What the Study Says.
Welcome back to What the Study Says. I'm Dr. Kai.
And I'm Dr. May. Today, well, prepare yourself. What if I told you the fix for a huge, like, multi-billion dollar problem in farming was basically painting zebra stripes on a cow? Sounds completely wild, I know, but there's real science here, and the potential is pretty significant.
It really is. And, you know, this kind of out there thinking often gets noticed by the Ig Nobel Prize. You know the ones, right? The awards that first make you chuckle, then make you really think. They celebrate research that's maybe unusual, definitely imaginative, but pushes us to see things differently. Valuable insights can pop up anywhere.
Exactly. And that's our focus for this deep dive. The 2025 Ig Nobel Biology Prize winner, get this title, Cows Painted with Zebra-Like Striping Can Avoid Biting Fly Attack. So, our mission today is to unpack this seemingly bizarre but actually brilliant finding. We're going straight to the research paper.
And we should be clear, the problem itself, biting flies on livestock. It's no joke. Mm. These things are a massive drain. We're talking estimates of what, $2.211 billion per year lost in the U.S. cattle industry alone.
Wow. Billion with a B.
Yeah. Think about it. The flies stress the cows out. So they graze less, feed less, milk yield drops. Plus, they're constantly doing those, you know, fly repelling things, head throws, stamping legs, twitching skin. It's exhausting for them.
Okay, so it's a huge economic and animal welfare issue.
Definitely. And what makes it trickier is that the usual fix, pesticides, well, the flies are developing resistance. Mm-hmm. So finding alternatives is becoming, well, really vital.
That makes sense. So where did the zebra idea even come from? It seems like such a leap.
Well, it wasn't completely out of the blue. There's been this hypothesis floating around for a while.
Yep.
About zebras. Why do they have stripes? Mm-hmm. One leading idea is that it actually stops biting flies from landing on them.
Huh. Really? Zebras.
Yeah, there are studies like from Caro and Igri and others showing flies seem to avoid striped surfaces. They even tested it with like striped coats on horses. And they found that narrower stripes, maybe less than 5 centimeters, seem to work best.
Fascinating. So someone thought, okay, horses, maybe cows.
Pretty much. So researchers in Japan set up this really neat experiment. They've got 6 Japanese black cows. Important that they're naturally all black, right? For contrast.
Yeah.
And they had 3 groups. One group got painted with black and white stripes.
Like actual zebras.
Exactly like zebras. Another group got painted with just black stripes. That was clever control to check if it was just the paint itself, maybe the smell.
Smart. And the third group?
Just plain cows, no stripes. The baseline control, they used this water-based lacquer, painted fresh stripes every day, kept them about 4 to 5 centimeters wide.
And then just watched them.
Yep. They observed them carefully, took photos to count the biting flies landing on them, and they recorded all those fly repelling behaviors, the head throws, ear beats, leg stamps, skin twitches, tail flicks, all of it.
Okay, so the moment of truth. Did painting cows like zebras actually work?
It absolutely did. The results were really striking. The cows with the black and white stripes, they had significantly fewer biting flies land on them. We're talking almost half as many compared to the plain cows and the black striped cows.
Half? Wow, that's not a small effect.
Not at all. And it wasn't just the fly count. Those behaviors, head throws, ear beats, leg stamps, tail flicks, all significantly lower in the zebra stripe group. They were just more comfortable.
So less swatting, less stress. But I saw something interesting in the paper. Skin twitches actually went up a bit. How does that fit?
Yeah, that's a cool detail, isn't it? The thinking there is that skin twitches are kind of a low-energy defense. So with way fewer flies bothering them overall, the cows didn't need the big energetic defenses like head throws as often. They just manage with the occasional less taxing skin twitch.
Okay, that makes sense. Lower threat level, lower energy response.
Precisely. And because the black-painted cows were no different from the unpainted ones, it really sealed the deal.
Mm.
It wasn't the paint. It was the visual pattern. The stripes.
So why do the stripes work? Is it like camouflage?
Not exactly camouflage.
Yeah.
The leading theories, based on other fly research, suggest a few possibilities. It might be about how the stripes modulate light brightness, or maybe how they affect polarized light, which flies use for navigation and finding water or hosts. Or it could be something that messes with their motion detection system as they get close to land, like it confuses their approach.
A visual illusion for flies. That's brilliant.
It really is.
So the big implication here is we potentially have a non-chemical way to control these pests, something better for the animals, and that gets around pesticide resistance.
Exactly. It's a really promising, welfare-friendly approach. And eco-friendly too, right? No chemicals leaching into the environment. And like you mentioned with the horse coats earlier, it's not completely unheard of in practice, just not widely adopted for cattle yet.
What's the catch then? if it works so well.
The main practical hurdle right now is just application. Painting stripes on cows every single day isn't really feasible on a large farm. So the next step is figuring out a way to make the stripes last longer, maybe different paint types or some other application method.
Right. It needs to be practical for real-world farming. But still, the core finding is amazing.
It truly is. Biomimicry at its best. Learning from nature.
So summing up this deep dive, that aha moment is pretty clear. Painting cows to look like zebras, it dramatically cuts down biting fly attacks, makes the cows more comfortable, and offers this elegant, potentially low-cost, eco-friendly solution. It really is a laugh-then-think discovery.
It absolutely makes you wonder, doesn't it? What other simple, ingenious solutions are already out there in nature just waiting for us to notice? Maybe hiding in plain sight, on an animal's coat, or a plant's leaf?
The great thought to end on. What else are we missing? If you found this dive fascinating, please subscribe to The Deep Dive for more explorations like this. And definitely share this one who doesn't love a story about zebra-painted cows solving a billion-dollar problem. Thanks for joining us.